National Broadcasting Company invites you by transcription to join The Chase. There is always the hunter and the hunted, the pursuer and the pursued. It may be the voice of authority, or a race with death and destruction, the most relentless of the hunters. There are times when laughter is heard as counterpoint, and moments when sheer terror is the theme. But always there is the chase.
Yes?
Dr. Harvey?
Yes?
This is the floor nurse in Ward 8, Doctor. Edward Kirk is being escorted to your office.
Thank you.
Doctor, one moment, please. Dr. Benson asked me to advise you against being alone with the patient for any length of time. He says it may be dangerous, sir.
Well, Kirk's behavior for the past 3 or 4 months has been exemplary, and the shock treatment seemed to be doing him some good. I won't have his confidence unless I talk to him alone. Please tell Dr. Benson I can handle the patient.
Very well, sir.
Here they are now. Come in. Hello, Kirk. You can leave us alone, orderly. Come over and sit down. Cigarette?
No.
How do you feel, Kirk?
Great. Nothing like being shut up in a nut house to make a man feel just great.
You were sent here, Kirk, because you attempted to murder a man. You weren't sent to prison because you were ill.
There's nothing wrong with me.
I'm afraid there is.
Why didn't they ship me to jail instead of here? 2 years with a bunch of lunatics? Who says I'm crazy? Who?
Kirk! One more outburst like that, and I'll have to send you back upstairs.
Sorry, Doc.
I want to help you, Kirk. You must believe that. One day, when we feel you're completely cured, you'll be a free man again.
Yeah.
Now, let's go over a few things once more and see if we can light some dark corners in our minds.
We're going to talk again, Doc, about the guy I nearly croaked?
Yes, we are. Now, why did you try to strangle him?
Why?
Yes. Why?
Maybe I didn't like his puss, Doc.
Is that the only answer you have for me?
Yeah.
You hated that man for a reason. Can't you remember what that reason was?
No. All I know is I don't hate him no more, Doc.
You don't?
You see, I got somebody else to think about now.
Who?
You really want to know, Doc?
Yes.
His name is Melville. Doc Melville.
The man who testified at your trial?
Yeah. That's the guy. He's a cutie, that one. Told the judge I was off my conk. Said I was a dangerous maniac. Needed to be put in a joint like this.
And you feel that he's the cause of all your troubles, do you?
Who else? He sent me up here for life, that's what. Who asked him to open up his lousy yap? If I ever get my hands on Melville, what are you doing, Doc?
Perhaps we'd better have our interview some other time. You're not in a very good mood today. I'm going to call your orderly.
Just a second, Doc.
Well?
You've been okay to me.
I've been trying to help you, as I said before.
You've been the right guy. That's why I want to ask you to do me a favor.
What is it?
I want to send a short note to a friend of mine. They won't give me no pens or pencils upstairs. They don't even let me have any laces in my shoes. Would you write the note for me now?
Yes, of course.
Thanks. You sit down at your desk over here and let me dictate.
Very well.
I'll make it short.
I'm ready, Kirk.
Dear Mary.
Dear Mary.
When you get this note...
When you get this note...
You'll have something to celebrate. Because I got news for you, baby. Big news.
Celebrate. Because I've got news for you.
Baby, big news.
Baby, big news.
I'm getting out of here now.
You're...
Sorry, Doc. But this is how it's got to be.
I'm leaving, Ellen.
Well, let me look at you, Dad.
All right. Do I pass inspection?
I think you're going to be the handsomest man in that lecture hall tonight.
Oh, sure. I don't mind telling you that, I'm rather nervous.
Nervous? Mm. The eminent psychiatrist, Dr. Richard Melville, nervous? Darling, you'll be a sensation. Yeah. Oh, I wish I could hear you make your acceptance speech when they give you the Dakins Award. Why do they always insist on making these things stag?
Because, my darling, even a doctor needs an occasional rest from his family.
Oh, Dad, that sounds suspiciously like insubordination.
Well, I'd better hurry. I'm late, Ellen.
Have fun, darling.
Lock the doors before you turn in. I'll be home around midnight. I have my key.
All right. Night, Dad.
Bye, dear.
Hello?
Is this Dr. Melville's home?
Yes.
Dr. Harvey speaking. I want to talk to Melville at once.
Oh, he's gone, Dr. Harvey. This is his daughter, Ellen. Can I give him a message?
Where did he go?
He's attending the Dakins Memorial Award banquet this evening. Is something wrong?
I'm calling from a state mental hospital. A patient named Ed Kirk escaped about an hour ago. He almost strangled me to death.
Ed Kirk?
Yes.
You mean that psychotic Dad testified against 2 years ago?
Yes. He's sworn to track your father down if it's the last thing he does.
Oh, what?
He's a dangerous, homicidal maniac, Miss Melville. And he'll never give up the chase until he sees your father in his grave.
You say he escaped an hour ago.
Time enough to get to your home if he managed to steal a car. I was only found in my office unconscious 5 minutes ago, or I would have called before this. I'll try to reach your father at the banquet immediately.
All right.
You'd better call your nearest police precinct. Ask him to send a guard around.
I'll call the police right now. Dr. Harvey.
Try not to worry too much. With adequate protection, your father will be safe. Goodbye, Miss Melville.
Goodbye. Oh.
Put it down, sister. Put it down.
What do you want?
Get away from that desk. I never did like telephones.
You're Ed Kirk.
Where's Melville?
You're the man who...
Where's your old man?
He isn't home.
Don't lie to me, sister.
You're breaking my arm.
Where is he?
I told you. Out.
When does he come back?
Very late.
You all alone here?
Yes.
You're his daughter, aren't you?
Yes.
For 2 cents, I'd choke the life out of you first.
Please. You're ill. You need medical
attention. I'm as sane as you are, sister, as anybody. It was only your old man who didn't think so. He put me in that asylum. It was his testimony that did it. So help me, I'll squeeze the life out of his throat with my bare hands.
No.
You're scared, aren't you?
Why should I be scared?
Because you know I mean every word I say. I'll make him crawl the way I crawled. Killing is too good for him. I only wish...
What are you staring at?
You.
Don't touch me.
I'll bet your old man's nuts about you, huh? I'll bet you even mean more to him... and living.
If you're wise, you'll give yourself up, Kirk.
Sure.
They won't hurt you if you do.
I can hit them harder through you, sister, and make them wait for it, too. I'll show him what it's like to eat his heart out. Sit down.
What?
I said sit down. Yes. Now, pick up that pencil and the sheet of paper. I'm in a regular letter-writing mood tonight, sister. Only I like to dictate my letters. Now, put this down. Dear Pa.
Dear Pa.
I'm going for a ride.
Ride?
With Ed Kirk.
With Ed Kirk?
It'll be just a short ride. For maybe 2 hours. Because at 10 o'clock sharp, he's gonna kill me. Write it.
All right.
I got my car outside, Princess. Let's get started.
Sergeant Hallinan.
Sergeant, this is Dr. Richard Melville, Holly Road. I was notified a few minutes ago that a man named Edward Kirk had escaped from the state mental institution.
Yeah, Doc, we got the description half an hour ago. We're on the lookout for him.
Yes, yes. Well, he's got my daughter with him.
What?
Yes, I just came in and found a note here. He says he's going to kill her at 10 o'clock.
I'll send out another alarm, Doc, right away.
Hurry, please.
You like the ride, sister?
I can see that you're enjoying it.
Why not? With a doll like you at the wheel, it's a pleasure.
What have you got against my father, Kirk?
Are you asking stupid questions?
All he tried to do was to get you medical care. You'd have been sent to prison instead.
Shut up and drive. I got my own way of squaring accounts.
What's the matter?
It's my head. Every once in a while, it starts to ache. Keep both your hands on that wheel.
Don't you realize that there must be a statewide alarm out for us now? Every highway patrolman within 50 miles will join the chase.
You think I can't outsmart a cop? Just you watch.
Yes. I know you're smart.
You do? Huh?
You must have been, to escape from that institution.
Oh, it wasn't hard, sister. Not when you got a medic who's dumb enough to trust you. His office was on the ground floor and it was dark. It was easy to slip on that white coat of his, hop out of his office window, and then walk across the grounds and out the gate without nobody paying much attention.
That was very clever of you, Kirk.
Yeah.
But you won't be clever enough to get away with murder.
No?
No.
Who says I want to get away with it?
You mean you're going to release me?
Sure. But you won't be alive to know when.
They'll track you down, Kirk.
Sure they will. They'll send me back to that crummy pen. I got nothing to lose, see? And a lot to gain. Yeah, a lot to gain. What's the matter?
Something's wrong with the motor.
You trying any tricks, sister?
No, I swear it. It must be the gas. I think we're running out of gas.
There's a filling station on the right. Drive in quick. I just made it. Look, I'll do the talking, sister. One wrong word out of you, and I'll bury this knife up to the hilt.
Evening, folks.
Fill her up.
Special?
Yes, special.
Right.
Don't look around like that, baby. There's nobody here but that station attendant. And I can take care of both of you if I have to.
Want me to check your oil?
No, the oil's okay.
Yes, sir.
What time does it say on that watch you're wearing, sister?
20 minutes past 9.
Mm-hmm. You got just 40 minutes more.
You folks figuring on going much further up the road?
Why?
It's blocked.
Who's blocking it?
The state troopers. They're looking for a guy and a girl who...
A guy and a girl who what?
Who, I don't know. There's, that's, 557, mister.
My wife will give it to you.
Your, wife?
Go on, honey. Pay the man.
Yes, of course. Here.
Thank you. I'll get you change.
Get out of this car, sister, quick. You and me are going inside that station.
What are you going to do?
Shut up and move.
I said an emergency, operator. This is Joe Moore at the Walker gas station. Get me the state troopers, Barrett, quick. And
you dirty stoolie.
No, Carter!
Back to the car, fast. We're getting out of here.
What time is it, Harvey? 9:45.
They've got to catch them. 15 minutes. Let's take they've got to find them.
Get hold of yourself, Melville. The police won't fail us. They've got every road blocked from here to the state line. 200 troopers have been alerted. Kirk can't get through that cordon.
Well, he may not even try. He may kill her in the car before they can stop him.
It's all my fault. I grew overconfident with Kirk. I thought he was on his way to a cure. We'd gone through everything. Shock, pentothal, hypnosis.
Hypnosis?
Yes, to try to get him to talk more freely, to probe into his subconscious.
Yeah.
But it didn't work. The only results we got were with a rather unimportant post-hypnotic suggestion.
How was that?
He'd obey the suggestion on a given signal, but that was all.
Oh, that may be the police. Hello?
Dr. Melville?
Yes?
Sergeant Hallinan.
Any news, Sergeant?
Well, yes, but not actually good.
Oh, is she...
Your daughter's still okay, as far as we know, Doc. One of our troopers just picked up a gas station attendant about 20 miles from here. He was slugged with a heavy can of oil.
By Kirk?
Must have been. We figure he's heading back this way again.
This way?
The road was blocked by our boys about half a mile from the gas station.
You see?
Unluckily, the attendant mentioned it before he was hit. Kirk must have made your daughter turn the car around.
Yes.
The attendant said she looked all right, though, when he saw her.
Oh, thank heaven.
We'll keep you alerted, Doc. You'll stay there at your house, won't you?
Yes, yes, of course, but hurry, hurry. There are very few minutes left.
Keep that needle at 45, sister. No more or less.
Whatever you say.
Time's getting short. Your old man must be chewing his lips off by now.
Can't you possibly understand that he's not your enemy, Kirk? He wanted to help you get well.
He hates me. He hates my guts. They all hate me. The whole world, they got it in for me.
Your head hurt you again?
It's getting worse.
You want me to stop the car so you can rest?
You stop this jalopy, sister, and I won't bother to wait until 10 o'clock. Somebody's following us.
I don't see him.
Keep your eyes on that road ahead. One light. Must be a motorcycle cop. But they ain't looking for a girl alone. I'm getting in back. On the floor. One peep. One forced move. If he asks you a question, and I'll jam this knife through the back of your pretty neck. And remember, get rid of him.
Fast. Pull over, miss.
Driving a little fast, weren't you, miss?
I thought I was under the speed limit, officer.
Where'd you just come from?
Hanksville, up about 10 miles north.
Where you going?
Scarborough.
You see anything of a lone couple in a car on your way down?
A lone couple?
Yeah, the man may have been wearing a white coat, the kind a doctor wears.
No, no, I didn't see them.
You sure?
Yes, quite sure.
What are you so nervous about?
Nervous?
Well, your hand's shaking on the wheel. Say, you haven't been drinking, lady.
Drinking?
All right, let's have a look at your license.
Here's the wallet.
Yeah. You're another one of these cocktail drivers, lady. You're going to be sorry. We got a test at the barracks that can spot... Hey, is this your license?
Yes.
You mean your name is...
Step on the gas, or I'll give it to you.
Hey! Hey, stop, or I'll shoot! Faster!
He aimed away from us. He wouldn't take the chance of hitting you. Turn off to the left here. He's behind us again. Drive faster. You better pray he don't catch up with us, sister. That's all I got to say. He's gaining. There's a shack up ahead on the left. Stop the car in front of it, sister. We'll see who makes the last move. We'll see.
Harvey, it's 1 minute of 10.
Easy, old man.
Well, why don't they call? Why don't they tell us what's going on?
I'm sure you'll get some good news any moment now.
I can't answer it, Harvey. I can't face it.
Stay where you are. Hello?
Dr. Melville?
This is Dr. Harvey speaking.
Sergeant Hallinan.
Have you found them?
Yes.
Is the girl all right?
So far.
Good work.
Wait a minute, Doc. The danger isn't over yet.
What do you mean?
One of our troopers cornered them in an abandoned shack about 5 miles from here. They're both inside. We've got 20 troopers surrounding the place.
Then why don't you close in?
He yelled out he'd kill her if we made a move. I think the only reason he hasn't done it yet is because we've cornered him. He knows we won't close in while he's got the girl and she's alive.
What are you going to do?
We know how to deal with the usual type of criminal, Doc, but this guy is insane. We figure you and Doc Melville may have some suggestions. After all, you're the psychiatrist.
Exactly where is the shack?
4.5 miles up Route 17, you take a right turn. You'll hit a second-class road. The house is 1/2 mile up on the left.
We'll be there immediately.
Right, Doc.
She's all right, Harvey?
Yes, but thank from you. Here on, it's up to us. Let's go.
Rock, turn that light on full on the window. You men on the right, don't make a move unless you get an order.
Sergeant.
Yeah.
How much longer are we going to wait?
Well, Dr. Harvey and Dr. Melville should be here any minute now.
Yeah, Kirk may not wait another minute.
We're holding our own so far. Did you send Jones and Murphy around the back with the tear gas?
Yes, sir. They're waiting for an order now.
Sergeant Hallinan?
Yes.
I'm Dr. Harvey, and this is Dr. Melville.
Is my daughter all right, Sergeant?
As far as we know. Kirk had her show up at the window just a few minutes ago.
You've done everything possible?
We've got the house completely surrounded, Doc. There's a tear gas squad in back, and two of my men are covering the door with Tommy guns.
I see you're using searchlights.
We have the whole area lit up like a circus. Everything's set, and yet we can't move in.
Sergeant, let me go in and talk to Kirk.
Are you crazy, Doc? Excuse me, sir. I mean, well, he hates you more than he does your daughter. All he's looking for is a chance to take a crack at you both.
I can't stand around and wait like this. We've got to do something.
Let me talk to him, Sergeant.
You, Dr. Harvey?
I don't think he hates me in spite of what he tried to do to me. Perhaps I can get close enough to reason with him.
Well, if you want to try, it's all right with me. But you better walk in across the lights where he can see you.
All right.
Come with me.
Stay away from the window, sister. Look at that production. Lights and all. We're getting to be big shots, ain't we?
Kirk! Ed Kirk!
It's Doc Harvey. You must have come here with your old man.
Kirk, can you hear me?
Sure, Doc. What's on your mind?
Release the girl and I'll see that no harm comes to you.
That's rich, Doc. You're making me laugh my head off.
You have nothing against the girl, Kirk. It's her father you hate, isn't it?
Yeah. Hey, you sure hit it on the head that time, mister.
Oh, Kirk.
Hey.
What?
Maybe I can get the two of you at once, sister.
Oh, no.
Hey, this is great. Hey, Doc.
Yes?
You want the girl? Send Doc Melville in instead.
Kirk!
You heard me. Send him in and she goes free. But make it fast. Getting tired of playing cops and robbers. I'm liable to make up my mind to let her have it inside of 2 minutes.
No, wait, Kirk. I'll tell her father.
Yeah. Tell him to join the party. I'm just itching to say hello.
Tell you it's a trick, Doc. He'll kill the two of you.
I've still got to try. I'm going in.
Melville, wait. I just remembered. You said you'd given him a post-hypnotic suggestion once. What was it, and how did he respond, Harvey?
It was a simple test to see how deeply the hypnosis had affected him. We told him to obey an order to turn to the wall whenever he was asked.
Turn to the wall. I'm going to try it.
It may not work anymore.
But if he's still under its influence, it's a suggestion he can't stop himself from obeying. It's my one chance, Harvey. I'm going to take it.
Here he comes, sister. Your old man in person. He fell for it.
You're not going
to... I've been waiting for this break for the whole 2 years. I don't care what happens to me anymore. All I want is a crack at him.
Kirk.
Shut up or you get it first.
Kirk? This is Dr. Melville.
Ha! Hiya, Doc.
Send my daughter out, and I'll come in.
First, you come in, Doc.
All right.
Use the door. And walk slower. And listen, I got your girl in front of me. You got a gun in your hand or a cop with you. She goes.
I'm alone and unarmed, Kirk. I'm coming, Kirk.
Wow. At last. Been a long time, Doc.
Release my daughter.
Sure. Right after I push this sticker through her chest. You hear, Doc? You're going to wait right there until I reach you.
Turn to the wall, Kirk.
Huh?
Turn to the wall.
What? What are you talking about?
You've got to obey me, Kirk. Don't try to fight it. You were given an order. You can't refuse. Turn to the wall.
No. No. I...
Grab him!
Let go of me!
Take him outside!
Let go of me! Let me go! Let me go!
Dad.
Oh, Daddy.
Oh, Daddy.
It's all right, dear. It's all right, Ellen. It's all right now.
In the animal world, there is the hunter and the hunted. Hound and fox, hawk and sparrow, chicken and worm. But who is to judge precisely which is the pursuer or the pursued as we enter the chase? The Chase was created and written for the National Broadcasting Company by Lawrence Klee. Featured in tonight's cast were Joe DeSantis, Jane Webb, Paul McGrath, John Stanley, Ken Lynch, and Merrill E. Joels. The Chase is directed and transcribed by Fred Way. Fred Collins speaking. Next week, a frightened New York housewife runs directly into danger as she joins the chase.
Listen to Mr. President this evening on NBC.